Find product links below and hundreds more videos on my channel.
Hi everyone, welcome back. So I needed to make a little example video for eBay for my listing of this lens, and so I figured I'd make that into a little quick tip for you guys on YouTube as well. And so the quick tip is that you could potentially get a fairly low-cost option for the lens that you want if you get one with a scratch. And so this will really depend on the lens and the scratch, but generally with something like a 50 millimeter or longer, it's almost most of the time going to be pretty much completely invisible. Whereas with wider lenses, you generally want to avoid scratches more. So, you know, with super wide angle lenses, you know, maybe something like 14, 16 millimeter, 18 millimeter, you definitely want to avoid scratches more. But even there, still, if they're very, very small, a lot of the time, they're not going to show up. And basically, the reason is that the scratch, like for example, right there, that big scratch right there, the scratch is actually completely out of focus. So it doesn't show up. And so as you can see right now, at f1.4, it's just not showing up anywhere in the image. And then, you know, if it was showing up, then, you know, we would see it. But I'll show you how we can see it. And so I'm going to close down my aperture to f16. And as you can see now, right there in the corner, we can see a slight bright area. And so that is, you know, this scratch actually showing up. But, you know, if we were shooting with a crop camera, then that scratch would actually just be completely out of the frame. And here with a full frame camera with 5D, even at f16, which is the smallest that this lens will go, the smallest aperture that this lens can do, even there, it's not, it's just a slightly brighter area that's out of, you know, that's sort of in the corner there. And so for most shots, it's not going to have any noticeable effect, even at f16. But then it sort of, the more we close the aperture, the more it sort of blurs away. And then at f1.4, basically completely nothing. At f2, nothing. And then 2.8, nothing. So, you know, in the apertures that generally, you know, if we buy an f1.4 lens, we buy it because most of the time we want to be able to use that f1.4 aperture. And so this is a nice way to get something that is actually going to cost you a lot less and still give you pretty much the same results. And I know some of you are going to wonder if it's going to affect sharpness. No, not really. It will affect sharpness. The thing you want to avoid is a lens that has been smudged. If it's got like a smudge or sort of a haziness on it from being like cleaned on a t-shirt or something, you can sometimes see those on eBay. Absolutely avoid that. That will actually reduce the sharpness of the lens quite dramatically. However, small scratches shouldn't have any effect on the sharpness or on anything else for that matter. And let's go to a slightly more extreme example of putting something in front of the lens. So as you can see right now, I have this cable tie, and when it's in front of the lens, you know, if it's over here, we can see it a tiny bit, but then when it's right in front of the lens, it just completely disappears. You know, we're not seeing any sort of huge black line on the image. It's just completely disappeared. And then what we will see is we can see the bokeh, the sort of out of focus area in the background. We can see that the shape of that changes a little bit. And that's the same as if we were to use, you know, these sort of bokeh filter shapes that, you know, you can buy and you can make them yourself. These are ones that I made just myself. And so it's going to have sort of the same effect as that. These ones are actually slightly too big for this lens. And so this isn't a good example, but basically, again, here we've changed the shape of the bokeh. There's no circular bokeh areas in the background, so you can't actually see the effect these are supposed to have. They're supposed to create these nice little shapes in the background, but I have no lights behind me, meaning that it's not gonna actually have any effect right now. But I'll post a link down below. They're actually really fun and pretty to play around with. And sorry, that's my cat. And so let's go to a more extreme example. And that would be that if I put my finger right in front of the lens right there, and the, okay, so my finger right now is sort of touching the lens at the front, and then it's right over the lens, and you can still see through my finger. And obviously, you know, the less I would have it in front of there, the less it would have an effect it would have. but that's like a really super extreme example of how much you can put in front of a fast, you know, large aperture lens like this and still, you know, not have any noticeable effect. And so so again, a lot of the time these little things won't actually have any effect. So I hope that was, you know, useful to you guys. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments, obviously. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon.